Shepherd of our soul, Shepherd of our soul, Savior of our soul, Lover of our soul. We are on the Lord's side. We will never give up. We are overcome.
Exalt your name. We thank you, O Father, for this day. Thank you, Father, for making it possible for your children to gather again. Father, you have done this, O God. You did it that we might think of our yesterday, know where to say, Father, we are sorry, and never to go back to sin again. Thank you, Father, for the breath of life you're giving to us, O God. We are breathing. That's why we are able to talk. That's why we are able to say we have planned to do this or that today. But the dead will never do that again. Jesus, we are grateful. Father, we are grateful. Father, this morning speak to me, O God, and speak to me in the language that we all understand. To the end that the privilege given us today will not be in vain. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father, because I know Satan will be expelled out of our midst, O God. In Jesus Christ's name, I have prayed.
Amen.
This morning we have a word of advice from the throne of grace titled Self-Examination Required. Self-examination required. Within the life we are living today, no matter how you think you are holy, no matter you think you are righteous, if you don't examine yourself really to know if what you are saying about yourself is true, you will fall into hell before you know that you are being a fool for so long. You will be in the bosom of the devil before you will realize that you have been fooling yourself in the presence of people and your presence for so long. So this morning, the Lord is saying, my children, you had opportunity again now to see yet another day. Examine your yesterday. If I had come yesterday, do you think you would have followed me? But the problem with humanity is that we have the courage all the time to examine other people. Humanity is very good in looking into other people's affairs, but forgetting their own. It's easy to preach to others, instruct others, and counsel others. But doing what you tell others to do is the problem. It's easy to come out and say, yes, preach it to you. But have I actually examined myself? Am I doing what I'm asking people to do? Hey, be prayerful. Study your Bible. Do this. Am I actually doing what I'm asking people to do? That is the problem in humanity. The Bible told us in 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 28, which we read every day, almost every time on this mountain. But let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup. In the other way, let a man examine himself, and let him come and preach and instruct. Let a man examine himself and let him advise other people. Let a man and woman examine himself and let him do whatever he's doing. Let a man and woman examine themselves this morning before they go out and enter any car. Because anything can happen. I am not prophesying evil. Let a man examine himself before doing anything, because at that stage you are, and anything happened there, the stage you are there is what God will use to judge you. So whatever you are doing, examine yourself. Examine yourself. If anything happened now, what is that thing that made Christ to tell me, get up, I never knew you. Let a man examine himself every second, every moment, every minute. Examine yourself more than you are talking. Examine yourself more than every other thing you are doing. Self-examination is required. The Bible says, help yourself first before you help others. Like in a plane, when they come to tell you, okay, when anything happens, make sure you help yourself first before you help others. So use those things first before you are help, even though it's your son or your daughter or your children, make sure you do your own first before you help others. That's why the Bible told us in Matthew chapter 7, 3-5. And why beholdest thou the mood that is in thy brother's eyes, but consider not the being that is in thy own eyes? For or how will thou say to thy brother, let me pull out the mood out of thy eyes, and behold, a beam is in thy own eyes? That is the problem we have today. I am a bishop. I am an apostle. So because of that, I am immune. All the Lord is telling me is to instruct others. Don't do this. Don't do that. And myself, I am doing it. He said, consider yourself first of all before considering others. Verse 5. Thou hypocrite, first cast out the beam out of thy own eyes, and then shalt thou see clearly to cast out the mute out of thy brother's eye. This is the problem we have today. This is why Christendom is in pandemonium. Because the blind are leading the blind. The deaf are leading the deaf. The pastors are not hearing from God. Members are not hearing from God. Everybody are just doing bizarre everywhere. And nobody is considering. Nobody is sitting down. Where are we actually going to? What are we actually doing? What is happening to us? Nobody. Everybody are comfortable doing whatever they are doing. Pastors are comfortable in saying. The members are comfortable in saying, as far we have money, as far things around us are good, every other thing, no problem. No matter what God says about us, it's not the problem. What the problem is, what we say about ourselves. We have the money to spend. I go out now, I enter my car, I drive out. Things are okay with us. But what Christ is saying about us, it does not matter to us. That is the problem we are having today. The blind are leading the blind. So let us examine ourselves now. Am I a blind father leading my blind children? Am I a blind husband leading my blind wife? At least let one be seen so that the rest can be able to follow the right road. But no, the husband is pretending to be spiritual. The wife, let us be living the life of pretentiousness. Husband is pretending, wife is pretending. Nobody's crying out. Say, Father, help me here. The Bible told us, self-deception is what is happening today. The Bible says in Galatians chapter 6, 3-5. Galatians 6, 3-5. For if a man think himself to be something, when he is nothing, he deceiveth himself. If a man give himself a name, a woman gives herself a name, you are holy, you are pure, and you give people the picture of holiness. You give people the picture of righteousness. Meanwhile, you are dirty inside. You are deceiving yourself. So let us examine ourselves now. What I'm telling Sister Richard, I may not say it with my mouth, but my behavior is telling Sister Richard that this man is a holy man. And if it is a lie, and you die, your lie, your punishment in hell will be 10-40. And I pray God will help us this morning in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Galatians 6:4. But let every man prove his own work, and then shall he have redress in himself alone, and not in another. For every man shall bear his own burden. Every man shall bear his own burden. Let me tell you something. In the presence of God, we shall come before the judgment seat. The Lord God Almighty will not use my own sin to judge you. If the sin that follow you there, the Lord will use to judge you. So let every man examine himself. Let every man pray his or herself away from sin before pray others away. Because it's your own body you carry before the presence of God. You will rejoice over your own work. You will suffer over your own pretentiousness. You will suffer over your own hypocrisy. We come here, we start shouting, hey! But in our closest, we don't do it. Let us examine ourselves. Am I not a hypocrite, pastor? Am I not a hypocrite believer? If your conscience have told you yes, go on your knees and beg to say, Father, this spirit of hypocrisy, deliver me from it. This spirit that is in me, making me to give Sister Ego another picture that is not me. Father, deliver me. The Lord wants to see my real picture. Self-examination. It is better to examine ourselves than setting exam to other people to write. That is what is happening today. The kind of God of these days, what they do is to set exam for other people. Pray. Ask God for mercy. Ask God for mercy. But their mouth will be shut. They will let make it to understand that they don't need to pray that prayer they are praying. Pray for deliverance. Pray. But they themselves will not pray. But meanwhile, in the night, they don't sleep. They are loaded with demons. They are confused. Nothing spiritually is going on well with them. But they come out and pretend and start saying, pray. That is a problem we are having today. And the Lord knows that people that somebody tell you to pray, is so free that the Holy Ghost will come there. Because the leader is an hypocrite. Let us examine ourselves. Are we not actually pushing ourselves to hell? We have all the opportunity to make heaven if actually we want to. I've come to understand, as far as I have breath in my nostril, as far as I have life, I have no reason to go to hell. This moment now, I have the opportunity to search myself to know where I am wrong and know what to do about it. But we wouldn't do it. But rather, we'll be prognosing, looking for those people who are falling down. Meanwhile, you are already lying down. I pray God will help us in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
1 Corinthians 13:5. Examine yourselves, whether ye be in the faith. Apostle Emmanuel, examine yourself, whether you are still in the faith. Prove your own self. Knowing not your own self, Sister Ego, don't know yourself again. You know when you are said lie. You know when you are sane. You know when you are weak spiritually. You know yourself. You know what you've been doing that you cannot do it again. get up now and cry out back to God. Now you know yourself how that Jesus Christ is in you, except you be reprobate, except you are not, you have hardened your heart now, except you are not placed yourself in a place that you are not supposed to be, except your ego have not so grown that you cannot be humbled again, except you are past the level of the people who examine themselves. I was telling you a man ago yesterday, a pastor said in Nigeria, when I went home, there's a level you get to as a man of God. God will not cast some certain sin against you anymore. I said, hey, cool. There's a level a man of God get to. Then we call them the generous. And God will not cast some sin against you anymore. Maybe the man mistakenly sleep with a member. God will not count that one anymore as a sin to you. God will understand that you are his general. Maybe somebody here is also saying that thing. God now understand my level now. I'm not in the level that this sin cannot take me to hell anymore. Until you get there, you will know that that sin can take you to even the bottomless pit of hell. I pray God will have mercy upon us in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us learn to try our way all the time, to know when to cry out to God for mercy and forgiveness. Let us learn, 2 Corinthians 13, verse 5 is what I just read just now. Let us learn to try our ways all the time, all the time. You are on the street, be trying your ways. Instead of you to be prognosing, looking for the next number to call, to start gossiping, talk to yourself. Use most of your time to talk to yourself. But most people use most of the time to talk about other people. Lord, help us on this mountain in the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible tells us in Lamentation 3, 39 through 40. Through 41, rather. Wherefore, doth a living man complain, a man for the punishment of his sins? Let us search and try our ways, so that if anything happen to you, you will know that God, I confess all this saying. I was always doing that. Yes, you have. Will you be saying, God, why did I enter hell when you never try your ways when you were on earth? Will you tell God, why am I in hell when you never confess your sin? Let us set and try our ways and turn again to the Lord. Turn again to the Lord. Let us lift up our hearts with our hands unto God in heaven. Try your way this morning and know those things that have sent to hell if Christ have come yesterday. Let us try our ways so that we'll not find ourselves in a place where we never bargained for. I pray God help us in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
James chapter 1, verse 22. 25. Be ye doer of the word we are hearing now, and not hearer only. Deceive your own selves. The Lord in his mercy is talking to us now. So people are thinking, I am above that. I've done it. This man is not talking to me. He's talking to Sister Rachel. No problem. For if a man be a hearer of the word and not a doer, if a man be the preacher of the word and not a doer, he is like unto a man beholding his natural face in a glass. For he, 24, for he beholdeth himself and got away his way, and straightway forgetting what manner of man he was. But whosoever looketh unto the perfect law of liberty and continueth therein, he being not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the work, this man shall be blessed in his deed. Let us put into practice what we are hearing every day. I am not boasting. this ministry is one of the most privileged ministries all over the world. That every blessed day, you must hear the word of God. You must hear the word that will prepare you to heaven. What are we going to tell God on the last day? That if we still ain't, God forbid, we have no excuse to go to hell. Nobody that spent 5 days or 2 days on this mountain have any reason to go to hell. Because the Lord God Almighty will talk to you every morning. And that money due will make you to be able to live a holy life throughout the day. The next day again, he tell you another one again. For you to be able, why will you go to hell? So this money on is, let us examine ourselves.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. Psalm 139:1-3. I'm stopping here. Oh Lord, thou hast searched me and know me. But some people are thinking God does not know them. He knows you. Oh Lord, thou hast searched me and know me. Thou knowest my down sitting and my uprising. Thou understandest my thoughts afar off. He knows everything. Verse 3. Thou compassest my path and my lying down and art acquainted with all my ways. God knows everything about us. Let us carry our body, our soul, our spirit to God. If Father, tear me apart, break me, destroy me, and remove me. You know the secret part of me. No matter this man is close to me, that's on this, he can know about me. But there's somebody who knows it. And that same person is the person you will stand before on the last day. Let us cry out to that, to such a man. Say, Father, search me, break me, remove me. You know everything about me. What my wife don't know, you know it. Search me for me. Humble me. And do that which only you can do in my life. I don't want to go to hell. The time we are now is the time of sin. Sometimes even the breath we have, you breathe outside there might cause you to sin. What you see can make you sin. So therefore, let us examine ourselves constantly. Cry out for mercy constantly, wherever you are. Make sure you are begging for mercy all the time. You know why? Because we don't know when the exit shall come. It can come at any time. And the state you wear when you give, when you breathe your last breath, that is the state that God will judge you with. And I pray to help me, help us all.
Amen.
Are you out there? You're not born again. This is an opportunity for you. Maybe you thought you were born again, but you were only a pretender. You are not actually born again. This is another opportunity for you now. Say this word after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I've heard your word. I've checked myself. I was not actually on the right path with you. But having heard this word this morning, I've decided to come out of darkness into your mother of light. Have mercy upon me, Lord Jesus. Forgive me all my sin. Take my name away from the book of death and write it in the book of life. I accept you this morning, Lord Jesus Christ, as my Lord and personal Savior. Come into my life and dwell in me. I am born again. All things have passed away and all things have become new. Thank you, Father, for saving my soul. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
I pray with you, brother and sister, if you have confessed this confession. My Father, my God, I thank you. I bless you, I worship you, I exalt your name, Lord. Thank you, Father, for your mercy. You have spoken to us this morning again. Father, you are a lovely Father. It's not your will for any of us to fall into hell. You don't want the breath you breathe into us to be in vain on the last day. You don't want the blood to shed for us to be in vain on the last day. Hence, you have done what you have done again this morning. Father, as many that came out of hell, I mean out of the way from to hell, out of sin, out of darkness to embrace you this morning, I pray, O God, that you give them the heart, O God, to always set their own selves, O God. Pride be taken away from them. Hold them in your own hands, O God. To the end that their confession today will not be confessed again in hell on the last day, but rather, I and they and every soul on this mountain, you have rejoicing with you on the last day. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, I have prayed.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hear the word of God. I think I believe somebody here will have a word to tell to tell to the Lord this morning. In 1 minute, talk to God this morning. You know what to tell him. Okay, my friend.
Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Father.
Bishop of our soul, Shepherd of our soul.